Hello and welcome back to Blackwatch Intel. My name is Crashy, and today we're going to be doing another installment of, I guess, what could be considered a series. In any case, we're going to be doing another video talking about the most underrated hero in Overwatch. Now, this one is going to be interesting because at any interval in time, if I feel like making a video like this, it just depends on where things are at in the game. So whenever I say it's the most underrated hero in Overwatch, you gotta kinda take that with a grain of salt, because obviously it's subjective to what's going on, and it's all just opinionated anyways. So it's really just the title of the series, for lack of a better term. So that said, Torbjorn is nuts right now. And I think it's been pretty well understood that Torbjorn was never really bad. I think it's his niche, you know, in nature and slow kind of startup and his slow beginning of the round that really makes him such a particular hero to, you know, to want to get into. But as someone who's been a fan of Torbjorn for quite a while, I gotta say, I've been having some ridiculous success with him on the competitive ladder. And I think I wanna outline why exactly that is. I kind of want to talk a little bit about his strengths, and I really want to kind of bring to the forefront just what it is that Torbjorn is able to do in various situations, not just defending. So, first and foremost, I want to go on ahead and say that there was a video from Lone Hawk that came out. I don't usually name drop on the channel, but I am going to go on ahead and say there was a video from Lone Hawk that came out, and he's basically saying that the meta is very in flux, and that it feels like things are running differently and people are playing the game a little bit differently because everything feels a little bit fresh. And I agree with that. I do think that there are things that are playing out a little bit differently, and it's because Doomfist is here. Now, because Doomfist is here, I feel like people are more open to trying new things, and that's something that Lone Hawk talked about in his video, and I'm definitely feeling that. So now we have people running these Doomfist dive comps, or, you know, they're really pushing the Reinhardts back in, and they're just trying all new kinds of things. And with that, I've been putting a lot of time on playing Torbjorn a little bit more in various scenarios. And one thing I've noticed, and it was something I knew, you know, whenever I got my hands on him, is that Torbjorn absolutely destroys Doomfist. It makes you make an impossible decision, because Doomfist is that type of hero that has to really take advantage of the three core abilities in his kit to find the kill and then instantly go get out, or find a pick and then instantly die. So when you jump in with Doomfist, you either die to the turret and get a kill, or you die to the turret, don't get a kill, or you kill the turret, die, and don't get a kill. And ultimately, it's just like it adds too much for him to handle, and it's a bad scenario to be in. Now, on the flip side of this, Torbjorn just, he's almost like a tank in the sense that he creates so much space. And I want to talk about creating space. And the best example I can give, and I don't know if this is the exact gameplay that I'll be using, but a great example is the first point defense on Hollywood, where you basically separate yourself from your turret. And this is how I like to play Torbjorn, and in order to create a lot of space, it makes them make a decision. Do we jump in for the fight, or do we jump in and kill the turret? You know, do we allocate resources like a Pharah or a Junkrat or something like that to kill the turret? Or do we, you know, aim that damage at the enemy team? And this is something that I think Torbjorn is vastly underrated for being able to do. And I think it's because of the general lack of knowledge that a lot of Torbjorn players have on how to proper utilize their, you know, their turret and their placement and their positioning. But ultimately, I more or less am never standing by my turret when I'm playing Torbjorn, unless I have to be or trying to get a new one up or something like that, or if I know I can really maintain it. But if you think they're going to be coming in for a fight, I try to create as much space as possible. In any case, I got a little sidetracked there. Torbjorn is great against dive, and I think that's something that is now becoming more prominent because of Doomfist. I think in more dive comps, you're going to start to see Doomfist and Genji and Tracer and Winston, and Torbjorn is actually phenomenal against all of them. Now, the fight against Winston is a little bit 50-50-ish. I mean, he can kill your turret, but it's an allocation of resources that you force them to make that decision, and so they have to do that. You know, you can create the space to make Winston jump in a certain direction, and you basically get a cooldown for free and then rebuild the turret. So ultimately, I think the only solid counter that a Torbjorn really has to worry about is Pharah. And even so, it's another allocation of resources. It's a hero pick that you're forcing the enemy team to make to be able to deal with the turret. And so keeping her in the sky allows for the hit scan player to take her down, or, you know, for more emphasis to be had on the team, rather than, you know, just being able to do damage to the enemies that she would normally be doing. So all in all, I think Torbjorn is overlooked in the ability to counter and be a solid defense hero. I mean, he scales harder as he is alive longer, being able to create more health packs, being able to build the ultimate and pop the Molten Core. And I'm excited to see if his viability goes up at all in the higher ranks, because I definitely know that on my Smurf that I've been playing on throughout Platinum, going in, you know, getting closer to Diamond, it's absolutely phenomenal play, because people just aren't that skilled at taking him down and getting, you know, getting the resources and the coordination to deal with me properly, on top of the fact that everybody wants to emulate Dive when they can, and if not done properly, well, they just kind of get ripped to shreds. Now, I did talk about a little bit of versatility with Torbjorn, and I don't want to just be a kind of one-track mind type of player when it comes to giving my opinions and my feedback and my commentary about a hero. And I think Torbjorn actually has a lot of strengths on control maps as well. As crazy as that is, I think it ultimately comes down to understanding how to play Torbjorn properly. And I'm not here to give you a guide or explain how you can, you know, win every single match with Torbjorn, but I definitely think he's overlooked, and it's this weird understanding that he's a turret building hero and that he's a defense hero and he makes armor and you really only want to use him on first point defense that ultimately makes him more niche than he actually has to be. It's an interesting perspective to have, knowing that a good Torbjorn is actually going to do so much in terms of creating an urgency for your enemy. And ultimately, he's just going to make more armor, he's going to put some shots in, and he doesn't always have to be standing right at the turret beating it with the hammer. So those are my thoughts. I think Torbjorn is much better than people give him credit for. I think in this heavy dive world, it's awesome to have a hero like him on your side, whether that be on attack or defense or on control or capture or whatever map you're playing on. I think there's a little bit of room for Torbjorn. So again, not optimal, definitely underrated. I'm excited to keep playing him more and more on my Smurf just for fun. You know, I genuinely have a good time with the turret and creating space. And I think that's just the overall theme I've been looking to go for in this video. So thank you so much again for stopping by. Please do not leave without leaving a like and subscribe for future content. We're going to be pushing out videos as often as we can, so trying to keep the topics fun and interesting, and I will see you for the next video. Do you feel your bones outshake? Do you feel the earthquake? Do you feel the fire inside of me? Do you see the sparks that I'm setting free? Does the beat take you over? Just